I think it was you that said that all Englishmen are either gay, collectors, or have bad teeth.
Yes, the English seem to be besotted with either collecting things or whacking each other's bottoms or all those wonderful things that make you English.
You're seen as being eccentric, either by the English or by the Americans. The Americans seem to like it. The English don't seem to know what to do with you. Do you think that's a fair assumption?
I think that's absolutely bang on. I don't think of myself as eccentric. I just think of myself as having fun. You know, life's generally too short to do anything other than just have fun, whether it's in your speech or in your actions or whatever you do. I've got my serious head on here now.
Yes.
Life's not worth living unless you're having loads of fun with it. I can't think of any better thing to do with life, can you? So no. Lay it in a shoebox there and stroke it once a week, but I can't think of anything better to do with it.
You're in this bizarre situation that you've had no hits, and yet you're very famous, or very few hits,
yes,
anyway.
Yes, damn it. It didn't work out how I planned. Yes, the fame one's an odd one, because I'd dig my own grave on coming on things like this and putting my face around, but all the aspects of fame are really unbearable.
You don't like performing in front of an audience, you don't like appearing on videos, you don't like being famous. Maybe you shouldn't be in this business.
No, I feel horribly compelled to keep on writing songs, because that's actually something I think I'm getting better at doing. I don't think we were so good when we started. It's just, you know, kind of... We had the young gang mentality.
Are you pretty much a non-star, an everyday guy at home?
Yes, aggressively mundane. I love the ordinary. I think it's much more interesting than the supposed fantastic. I do feel genuinely uncomfortable with all the kind of star trappings, which I've tried to stay away from. I think it's what you want when you're young and daft, and now I'm old and daft. I don't want those things. So.
Two kids?
Yes, I've got them on me now. Shut up. It's like doves, you know. Two kids, yeah. God, they're beautiful, but you're not supposed to say that, are you? You're not supposed to be a kid bore.
Of course you are.
So I used to hate kids until I had my own, but, you know, the second your own come out, it's like, you are God, you know, you are Dr. Frankenstein, you've made life, so it all changes. I still can't stand other people's kids, though.
You mentioned God then, and that was a turning point.
Sorry!
That song.
Sorry! Go back to bed.
Particularly in America, mainly because it caused such a...
Yes, a little furore creature. It did a bit, yes. We had a song called Dear God, which got up some Americans' noses. I still get the hate.
Did that upset you?
Well, it does, you know. Only the hypocrisy of it upsets me. That you can bring into question superstitions and things like that, and then, you know, people get so aggressive, which is, and so nasty, which is surely totally against what Christianity is supposed to be about.
The strange thing is, it actually had a reverse effect, didn't it? Because it launched your career in America.
Well, it did. I mean, most people thought that, hey, you guys, brand new band, right? No, sorry, old chap, been around for a few centuries.
Shuffle round in circles. They're black cars.